the Arabic class. In our previous lessons, a lot has been discussed about money. We have spoken about the definition of money, its functions or uses, the ways by which people misuse them, and so on and so forth. In our lesson today, we'll be discussing some of the ways or some of the appropriate or proper ways by which money should be handled. And when I talk about proper ways of handling money, I'm talking about the currency that is spent in the country Ghana. Ghana's currency, that is the Ghana cedi or the peswa. Proper ways or appropriate ways by which you can handle them. The first point I'll talk about as a way of handling cash or currency appropriately is by ensuring that your hands are clean. By ensuring that your hands are clean before handling the currency, note or coin. Ensure that your hands are clean before handling any note or coin. You must not touch or hold our country's currency with filthy or dirty hands. It must not be done that way, because we spend a lot of money bringing our local currency into being. We pay dollars, we pay other foreign currencies before we are able to print out the Ghana cedi notes and the coins. So if you want to handle them, you handle them with clean hands. The second point I'll talk about is, do not stain the notes with oil, grease, ink or dye. You must not stain the currency with any of this: oil, grease, ink or dye. As it was said in the first point, we handle it with clean hands, and as such, we handle it very well so that we don't stain it with oil, grease, ink or dye. The third point I'll talk about is, do not write anything on the note that we have with you. Do not write anything on the note. Some of us use the notes, the currency note, as our notebooks. We use them as our notepads. By writing our names on it, on them, writing telephone numbers, signing signatures, addresses, and then also writing directions for people to be able to locate you. All these are bad practices that must be done to the country's currency. It must be handled with care and not writing names, addresses, telephone numbers, and then the rest on them. The fourth point I also talk about is, do not perforate holes in the notes or coins. The notes must not be perforated before. A perforator, we all know what a perforator is. It's a tool or a device that is used to create holes in papers. Some of us use it for currency notes. It is an offense to do that. So the notes must not be perforated. Neither is the coins also supposed to be perforated. So it's also a bad process that we must desist from. The fifth point I'll talk about is that we should not fold the note in any form. I am going to demonstrate to you how the currency note is supposed to be folded. You must not fold it in any form, being rectangular, being a square, or in a pyramid form. When you do that, you destroy the currency. This is your currency. This is a 20 Ghana cedi note. I'm going to show you how it should be folded. The 20 Ghana cedi or any note of the country must be folded like this. Try to put it like this, and then kept neatly in your pocket, in your money collection boxes, in our offering bowls, and so on and so forth. You have to fold it like this, but not being folded in this form. Neither should it be folded like this, nor being folded like this. This is the pyramid we are talking about. The money should not be folded this way. Neither is it supposed to be folded this way. This is a rectangular form. And then being folded in a square form is like this. This is not how it should be folded. But the right way to fold your currency should take this form. I believe we have all seen it and we are going to take it into practice. Alright. The next point I'll talk about is, do not crumple the money before keeping them in your pocket. Do not crumple. This is the amount. Let me bring out the money again. This is the money. It must not be crumpled. Crumpling money is like this. Some of us handle the money this way and then put it in our pocket. It's also a bad practice. It must not be crumpled, it must not be folded in this way. The only appropriate way to fold money should be in this form, so that you keep it in your pocket, you keep it in your wallet, you keep it in your money collection boxes, and so on and so forth. The second point, do not crush or rub hard objects such as stones, metals, or wood against the coins. Some of us mostly do that. I've even done it before, but it's a very bad practice to continue. So we must not crush hard objects such as stones or metals or wood against the coins. It must also be handled with proper care. The eighth point, we should desist from keeping money under our braziers. This goes to the females. Money must not be kept under our braziers, our underskirts, or tied them at the end of our clothes or handkerchiefs. Our mothers and then grandmothers also are fond of doing this. They tie the note very tightly at the edge of their clothes and their handkerchiefs. That's also a bad practice. It is not a proper way to handle the currency. The last point I'll talk about to end it all for today is that we must give proper and honest account of money entrusted in our hands by others. Money that has been entrusted in our hands must be given proper and honest account to it, so that you can always and always be entrusted with bulk cash or bulk currencies. Thank you.